To install BlenderKit, go to User Preferences, click Install from File and find the add-in on your hard drive. Then enable BlenderKit. Paste your API key. Check the database folder. If it is not in the location where you want to store your files, set it to a different location. Click Save Blender Settings. Go to 3D View, Tools, BlenderKit. Now you can start using BlenderKit. On top of the panel, there are three buttons for search, upload, and rating of the assets. Next to it, you can switch between different types of assets: models, materials, brushes. Scenes are here too, but they are work in progress now. Let's switch to materials. Try to click one of the categories and hit Show Asset Bar button. You can see we have some results. Drag a material to the scene. You can see the material starts downloading, but you can continue your work. If AutoMap is on, the add-on also creates UV map for you. When the material is downloaded, it automatically assigns itself to the object in your scene. It assigns to the active material slot on the object. Now, let's try brushes. Select any object and go to Sculpt node. I'll switch on multi-resolution modifier and increase subdivision just a bit so we can see the results of our brushes. Again, I can click one of the categories and see what comes out of it. Click on one of the results. You can see that the brush is downloading. After the brush downloads, I can use it to sculpt something. I can also click on several brushes and wait for them to download. Then I can use the brushes faster, because they are already on my hard drive and they will stay there and won't be downloaded again also in other scenes and other files. Let's try models now. Switch to models. I can drag and drop models to scene by will. You can see the items snap automatically on the surfaces in the scene. You can use the mouse wheel to rotate the objects by 90 degrees. You can also switch on randomization of the rotation. This makes scenes less symmetric with less work.